The purpose of this video is to explore the concept of closure at the high school level. Now, every year students go through this concept and it can be very confusing, so please pay attention to the definition and hopefully this video will make it a lot more simple for you to understand. Now, a common misconception that students have when dealing with closure is they think of it as a negative concept. Now, this property is actually very positive. If we perform an operation, and in high school we'll deal with just addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, a set of numbers is closed for that given operation if we take two numbers from that set, perform the operation, and the result is also from that set. So think of this as a closed box. We have the whole set of numbers, we perform addition, subtraction, etc. on two of those numbers from that set. The result will also be in that closed box without opening up to a larger, different set. In order to get this point across, let's use some common number sets from algebra and pre-algebra to understand this concept. So the first set of numbers we'll use is the counting numbers. The formal name is the natural number, so just your 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth. Do all operations work all the time for all these sets? If they do, then they will be closed. If not, then they are not closed for that set. So remembering those two definitions, closure and natural numbers, I can test each operation to see if this closure concept works. So if I take any two natural numbers and I add them together, will the result always be another natural number? The answer is yes. You can try many examples. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 plus 9 gives me 16. 16 plus 5 gives me 21. Always another counting number. The same cannot be said as true for subtraction. If I take two natural numbers, the result is not always another natural number with subtraction. 9 minus 5 does give me a natural number 4, but if I do the reverse, 5 minus 9, I result in a negative. The natural numbers do not result in a negative, so the set of natural numbers are not closed for subtraction. I repeat the same process for multiplication. Try exhaustive examples, and I see that the set is closed. Division does not work because we could get fractions if I divide a larger number from a smaller number. Another set of numbers commonly explored in high school is the set of integers. Now, this set expands upon the natural numbers. It also includes the number 0. And the opposite of the positive numbers, so negatives, but not the fractions in between. Now we can go through the same set of exhaustive work with the four operations for integers, realizing if we have just one counterexample, then the result is no, not closed. But for the first three operations, addition, subtraction, and multiplication, we can see that this set of integers is closed for those operations. We saw that the natural numbers worked for addition. Same thing holds true for integers. If I take any two integers and add them together, I will result in another positive number, negative number, or a zero, but no fractions in between. Subtraction now works because I can take 5 and subtract 9, and I will get negative 4, which is included in the set of integers, so I'm okay. So the set of integers is closed for subtraction. Multiplication, if you think about it, negative multiplied by negative is positive, positive multiplied by positive is positive, positive times a negative is a negative, and zero multiplied by anything is zero. So all results will be in that set of numbers. So that is also closed. Now division is not closed because, again, if I take a smaller number and divide it by a bigger number, I would get a fraction or a decimal in between some of these integers on the set. So this set is not closed for division. The third and final set of numbers that we'll explore is a set of even numbers. These are all numbers that are divisible by 2, so 2, 4, 6, 8, and so on. If we think of any two even numbers, 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 plus 8 is 14, 14 plus 10 is 24, the result is always going to be another even number, so this set is closed for addition. Now in terms of subtraction, this can be a little tricky. If I take two numbers and subtract, I'd result sometimes in a zero or a negative number. For example, if I do 4 minus 4, I get 0, which is not even. If I do 8 minus 10, I get negative 2, which is also not even. So this set is actually not closed for subtraction. Now, this is a technical weird concept, but we have to follow by the rules and the definition. Let's think about multiplication. If I take any two even numbers, my result is always going to be another even number. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 times 8 is 64. 10 times 8 is 80. The result is always another even number, so that is a yes. This set is closed for multiplication. And division, just like the other two examples, we can result in a fraction if I take a smaller number and divide it by a bigger number. So the result would not be another even number, so this set is not closed for division. Now, for most high school math classes, this will be sufficient. If you have to do anything more complicated, like an irrational number minus an irrational number, you want to think critically and test some things out. Any counterexample would be a no. So for example, if I take an irrational number minus itself, say negative 2 minus negative 2, I end up with 0. 0 is not an irrational number, so that set is not closed for subtraction. So anything more complicated, you want to test things out and see how the results go. But hopefully this is enough information. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. If you want any more videos on these concepts and properties from algebra and arithmetic, please leave me a comment or a suggestion. Thanks again so much for watching. Please continue to visit my channel for more updated math videos.